J-E-L-L.
The Jell-O program, starring Jack Benny with Mary Livingston and Phil Harris and his orchestra. The orchestra opens the program with Boo Hoo. Shopping, movies, bridge. Many women are likely to spend their afternoons these days in one of those three ways. But shopping, movies, or bridge sometimes means that you get home a little late and have to hurry with dinner. But never mind that, even if you have less time than usual, you can always serve a dessert you'll be proud of. Jell-O. Jell-O takes so little time to prepare, and it tastes downright delicious. Your whole family will enjoy Jell-O's true fruit flavor, flavor that comes from fresh, ripe fruit. Try strawberry, raspberry, cherry, orange, lemon, or lime, but be sure you get the real thing. Be sure you get genuine Jell-O. Accept no substitutes, because only genuine Jell-O has that extra rich, fresh fruit flavor. Remember to look for the big red letters on the box. They spell Jell-O. Ladies and gentlemen, after a week in the desert, we bring you that sun-baked comedian with the warmed-over jokes, Jack Benny.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Hello again. This is Jack Benny, that little ray of sunshine, just back from a week at Palm Springs and feeling twice as healthy as ever before, and anything but anemic.
Well, that's fine, Jack. That's fine. Did you get on there to get rid of your cold?
Yes, Don. My cold and Fred Allen. The cold doesn't bother me anymore.
Well, tell me, Jack, have you had any more dreams about Allen since last Sunday?
Yes, I have, and it certainly makes a lie out of that old saying that you meet a better class of people in your dreams. Anyway, tonight I'm going to put that town hall ghost in his place once and for all.
What are you going to do, Jack?
Well, you know, Don, this is my big triumph. Tonight I'm going to play the bee on my violin and redeem myself in the eyes of my listeners. And believe me, I'm going to town.
Well, good luck to you, Jack.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Don.
Oh, how are you, Mary?
Hello, Heifetz.
Hello. Now, wait a minute, Mary. Even though I do appreciate the compliment, I think it's hardly fair to compare me with Heifetz. I don't think Heifetz would approve of that.
Don't worry, he'll get the gag.
Well, I hope so.
Say, Jack, did you hear that 10-year-old boy play the bee last Wednesday night?
Yes, Mary, I did.
Wasn't he swell?
Well, yes, for a kid 10 years old. Of course, I thought his crescendos were rather abrupt, and it seemed to me that his allegrettos lacked pace. You know what I mean, Mary?
Yes, you're jealous.
Yeah, well, I'm not jealous. I can play the bee with one hand and Love and Bloom with the other.
Yeah. Gee, if you can hold a stick between your toes, you can direct yourself.
Yeah. Some nifty retort reminds me of another joke. That's it, doesn't it? Kenny, it's your cue.
Say, Jack.
Yeah. Oh, hello, Kenny. Hello.
Hello. Have you got a minute?
Sure. What's on your mind?
Well, I'm kind of worried about something. Look, Jack, garage rent is pretty expensive here in Hollywood, isn't it?
Garages? Yeah, they run about $15 or $20 a month.
Boy, that's a lot. Then there's automobile insurance, isn't there?
Yes, that runs you about $100 a year. Why?
Gosh, and on top of that, gas and oil and tires? Gee, that's bad.
Well, Kenny, why all this worry about garages, insurance, and everything?
I just bought a raffle ticket on an automobile.
Well, don't worry, Kenny. You haven't got a chance in a million of winning.
Oh, boy, that's a load off my mind. Say, Jack, are you going to play the bee tonight?
Is he? He's going to play the bee with one hand, Love and Bloom with the other, and sneeze pennies from heaven.
Thanks, Mary, but that's exaggerating.
Say, Jack, are you a little nervous tonight? You know.
shaky or anything?
Well, naturally, Phil. It's a big night for me. And say, Phil, did you augment your orchestra like I asked you to, you know, make it symphonic?
Yes, I did, Jack. I added a couple of hoboes, a zither, and a musical saw.
Well, that's a different sort of a thing anyway. Couldn't you get an organ grinder?
Well, I tried, but his monkey was on a sit-down strike.
Say, Phil, your orchestra does look pretty snappy tonight, all dressed up for the occasion. Did they get new tuxedos?
Oh, no, they just had their lapels shined.
Oh, their lapels shined. Well, well, that is quite a glare there.
Wait till they stand up and turn around.
Maybe.
By the way, Jack, who's going to pay these extra musicians? You know, the ones I hired tonight.
I don't know, Phil. Take it up with the sponsor.
I did, and he washed his hands of the whole thing.
Sanitary fellow, isn't he?
Yeah.
Well, don't worry about it, Phil. We'll straighten it out. You know me. Come in.
Mr. Benny?
Oh, you, Yes.
I want to take this opportunity of wishing you and your violin a very, very successful performance.
Well, thank you. That's much better. And who might you be?
I might be a music lover, but I'm not. Goodbye.
These pets. Doesn't NBC know you can buy a lock for a dollar? Play, Phil. Swing Low from the picture of the same name, played by Phil Harris and his augmented orchestra. Say, Phil, I didn't hear that fellow with the saw. Why didn't he play?
Well, he's a union carpenter. He can't work on Sunday.
Oh, I see. By the way, Phil, aren't your mother and sister Lucy Bell coming up to hear me play tonight?
I don't know. Why?
Well, it would be a kind of an inspiration to have Lucy Bell here. Come here a minute, Phil. I'm going in the other room and call her up.
Well, go ahead.
Keep the gang occupied while I slip away. After all, it's none of their business. Remember, keep it a secret. Huh?
Okay, Jack.
It's delightful, it's delightful.
Where are you going, Jack?
None of your business. It's a secret.
While Jack is making a secret phone call to Lucy Bell, let me divert your attention to Jell-O. Jell-O is just as sweet and tempting as Lucy Bell, and you don't have to be in a phone booth to enjoy it. So remember, always dial J-E-L-L-O, and if the lime is busy, you can still get strawberry, raspberry, cherry, orange, and lemon. Goodbye.
Say, Don.
Yes, Mary?
Let's open his door and listen in on Jack.
Oh, he might not like it, you know.
What's the difference? Come on, fellas.
Okay. Oh, boy, secrets.
Yes, I do, Lucy Bell. I do, too. Oh, you're just saying that because I'm Phil's boss. Are you coming up to broadcast tonight? I'm going to play the bee, you know. Oh, come on and hear the great big man play the fiddlesy whittlesy. Oh, please, pretty please.
Ain't he the sheik?
Shh, Kenny.
You will? That's swell. Gosh, I can hardly wait till you get here. Goodbye, Toots.
It's delightful, it's delightful.
Well, Don, let's get back to the grind.
How'd you make out, Jack?
Well, it so happens, young lady, I was phoning my tailor.
Oh, yeah? Since when have you been calling him Toots?
Well, that's his name, Toots Ginsburg. Fiddlesy whittlesy. Now, listen here, listen.
Oh, baby, talk to your tailor, huh?
Well, he's a young fella.
Why didn't you order a suitsy whoopsie?
You're all so funny, you guys.
Why don't you fellas leave Jack alone?
Yeah.
I know how he feels, for I, too, have love.
Why, Kenny?
Oh, cut it out, fellas. Fine bunch of pals I got around here.
Oh, the great big man can't take it.
Cut it out now. And with Alan listening in, too. Come in. Hello, Andy.
Hiya, Jack.
Well, Andy, I didn't expect you here tonight, much.
Well, I came over to hear you play the bee. You know, my mother thinks you're a wonderful violinist.
Well, thanks, Andy, that's fine.
Of course, she thinks I'm a good singer, too.
Kind of sorry you spoiled the compliment, huh?
Hello, Andy.
Hello, Daisy. I was going to call you Saturday night, but one of my hogs took sick.
Well, I guess your family comes first.
Now, Mary, you shouldn't say that to Andy.
Why not? I haven't had a laugh for two pages.
Oh.
Say, Buck, when are we going to play cowboy again and look for Cactus Face?
We got a new villain now, Andy, although his name isn't Cactus Face.
Oh, you mean Rattlesnake, Alan?
That's the vomit. And any day now, we may have to hit the trail for New York.
Did you hear him last Wednesday when he said you were anemic?
Yes, I did, Andy.
You know, his voice gets on my nerves.
Well, I wouldn't bring that up if I were you. But he should talk about me being anemic. Get this, Andy. Come here, everybody. Listen, that Alan is so anemic that when he eats a blood orange, his veins jump up and down with glee. Is that a good one?
That's good.
Yeah.
Come here. Jack, do you want another one you can pull on him?
Yes, and if he gets fresh again, I'll do it next Sunday. What's the gag, Andy?
Well, you say that Alan is so pale that when he sleeps between two sheets, the bed looks empty.
I'll never be able to say that without laughing, you know?
Say, Jack, I got one.
What is it, Phil?
Fred Allen is so anemic that he has to stick out his tongue to get color in his face.
Oh, that's a feat. I hope he's listening in.
Yeah, I'll bet he's so embarrassed he's yawning.
Well, that's just to put up a front. Now.
Hey, Jack, I got one for you.
You have, Kenny? Let's hear it.
Oh, boy, this is a honey.
Well, go ahead, Kenny. What is it?
Fred Allen is so anemic that if you gave him a transfusion with whitewash, he'd still look better than Jack Benny.
Oh, yeah? What's funny about that?
I don't know. Sing, Kenny.
You better. By the way, your option looks a little anemic, too.
Well, then it matches my salary.
Come on, Mary. That kid is getting too smart.
And don't let him listen to Alan.
Playboy.
Good night, my love. The tired old moon is descending. Good night, my love. My moment with you now is ending. It was so heavenly holding you close to me. It will be heavenly to hold you again in a dream. The stars above have promised to meet us tomorrow. Till then, my love, how dreary will be the new day. So for the present, dear, we'll have to part. you're mine, sweetheart. Chimes are ringing, night is singing a parting melody. While you're sleeping, keep my heart under your pillow. Good night, my love, the tide old moon is descending. Good night, my love, my moment with you now is gone. Have to part. Good night, my love. Sleep tight, my love. Remember that you're mine, sweetheart. Good night.
Sung by Kenny Baker, pride of the Jell-O program, when he sings.
Ain't it the truth?
Yeah.
Well, Jack, a telegram came in for you while Kenny was singing.
Take it, Mary. I'll read it later. My musical debut tonight. And now, folks... Oh, I didn't see her. Hello, Lena.
She came up to wish you good luck.
Well, well, that's mighty sweet. She hasn't been up here in a long time. Huh?
Go ahead, Lena. Congratulate Jack.
Well, thanks, Lena. I know that comes from your heart. Although most of it didn't get here.
It must have stopped at her Adam's apple for a visit.
Yeah, quiet, Mary. That's Kenny's fiancée. Isn't she, Kenny?
Yeah.
What's fiancée? French for dope.
Now, Lena, if you want to hear me play, you sit right down there alongside of Andy.
All right.
Oh, shut up.
Boy, a caveman.
Here come my folks now, Jack.
Well, hello.
Hello, Mrs. Harris. How are you, Lucy Bell? I'm sure glad you got here, Mrs. Harris.
Well, son, I wouldn't miss your concert for anything.
Well, are you glad to be here, Lucy Bell?
Oh, sure. I'm just tickled pink.
So would Jack be if he wasn't anemic.
Mary.
She's quite right, and I think Miss Allen showed mighty poor taste to mention it.
But, Mrs. Harris, I'm not anemic.
Now, that's just... nothing to be ashamed of, son.
Oh,
you
well,
you
I'm...
just haven't been eating the right thing.
Oh. Mother, he looks all right to me.
That's just your heart talking, Lucy Bell. You know he looks awful.
But, Mrs. Harris,
now,
I'm not...
Now, I brought you something that'll fix you right up. Cod liver oil.
Well, I don't like cod liver oil.
You better take it, son. Now, come on, open your mouth.
I won't.
Throw in a herring and he'll snap at us.
No, I like gefilte. Well, all right, Mrs. Harris, I'll take it, but I don't need it. It's just to please you.
All right. Oh, open your mouth.
Oh, that Allen. Ooh. Ah. Ooh. Ooh.
Now, that wasn't bad, was it, son?
No, ugh. U-U-G-H there. Kenny, what are you screwing up your face for?
Boy, have I got an imagination.
Mm. Fine thing. Now when I play my violin solo, I'll be making faces back at the audience. Mary, what are you laughing at?
I just read that wire that came for you.
Yeah, well, if it's so funny, let's hear it.
It says, Jack Benny, NBC Studio, Hollywood. Best wishes on your solo tonight. Stop.
Well, go ahead. What is it?
Heard you play the violin in your new picture, College Holiday. You should be in the good earth.
Very funny. Who's that from?
It's signed Ching Ling Allen.
I thought so. Play, Phil. Oops, I can still take that stuff. Slumming on Park Avenue from the picture On the Avenue, played by Phil Harris and his orchestra. That oil. And now, ladies and gentlemen, as our feature attraction this evening, I am going to play the bee. And as I said before, vindicate myself in the eyes of the public. Now, before going to my number, I want to say that I do not entertain any hard feelings toward that certain New England boiled comedian. In fact, I could almost forgive him for keeping that 10-year-old boy up till all hours of the night in an attempt to belittle a man whom he once called friend. I did not come here to praise Alan or to bury him. But what I am going to do tonight, I am doing in the name of justice. Thank you.
Jack, a couple of more telegrams just came in.
Thanks, Don. Take them, Mary. This is certainly a busy night. Oh, Kenny, you better arrange a few more chairs. People are still coming in.
Okay.
Oh, Jack, here's a wire from the mayor of Waukegan.
The mayor, eh? Not Bitey Talcott. Well, I knew my hometown would come through. Good old Bitey. I used to go to school with him.
Why doesn't he ever come out here to see you?
He will as soon as he graduates.
Don't mind her, Bitey. What does he say in the wire, Mary?
He says that, dear Jack, all Waukegan is proud of you tonight. Stop. Right after your broadcast, we are going to hang a picture, or you, in the city hall.
Let me see that. That says hang a picture of me, not or me.
Oh, you're always so fussy.
Well, then read things right. Say, Phil, what time is it?
It's about 8:55, Jack.
Well, we better get going then with my violin solo. Are the boys all ready?
Sure are.
Wake up, man.
And now, folks... Hey, what's that?
The mayor just graduated.
Oh, yeah, he's pretty smart and my friend. Come on, Phil, get the boys tuned up.
Right, Jack.
Come on.
Popcorn, peanuts, and cracker, Jack. Get them while they're hot.
Program, programs. You can't tell one note from another without program.
Jello, Jello, get your Jello here. None genuine without the big red letters on the box. Here you are, sir.
Earmuffs, get your earmuffs here. You can't enjoy the show without earmuffs.
I wanted this to be high class. Hey, Kenny, get my violin before someone starts selling balloons.
What?
I said, get my violin.
Where's the ticket?
I got it out this morning. Where's the ticket? My violin is in the case behind the piano.
Okay.
Now hurry up, will you? Well, introduce me, Don.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jack Benny will now play that much-talked-of composition... Schubert's immortal classic, The Bee.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. you. Kenny, hurry.
Oh, Jack! Jack! Jack!
What's the matter, Kenny?
Your violin is gone!
Gone?
Oh,
why, it can't be. I left it in the case right behind the piano.
Well, here's the case, and it's empty.
Oh, well, now, nobody get away with that, buddy.
Quiet, everybody! Quiet! I'll handle this. Lock that door and close those windows. Now, nobody leave this room. All right, come clean. Somebody in this room stole my violin. Somebody hired, most likely, by Fred Allen. I can have the police here inside of 3 minutes. Now, come on. Who took that violin? Quiet! Now, this is your last chance to confess. Who stole it? Come on.
I know who took your violin, Mr. Benny.
All right, stranger. Who took it?
Your violin was...
Yes, yes?
Your violin was taken by...
This will be continued next Sunday night. Who took Jack's violin? Was it the mysterious stranger? Was it Fred Allen? Was it the credit company? Tune in next Sunday night and find out. Playboy. Have favorite desserts of our own, but Jell-O chocolate pudding is one dessert that pleases everyone. It has the mellow homemade flavor, the grand chocolatey taste, the real old-fashioned richness that you enjoyed so much when your mother used to make chocolate pudding. But Jell-O chocolate pudding is even smoother, creamier, more chocolatey, and much easier to make. Just follow these simple directions. Mix the contents of one package of Jell-O chocolate pudding with milk. Cook and stir over a low flame until the mixture comes to a boil and is thick and satin smooth. It takes only a few minutes. Then cool and serve in sherbet glasses. One package will give you enough for 6 delicious servings of chocolate pudding that is absolutely the best. And it also makes a grand filling for pies and cakes. Jell-O chocolate pudding sells for the same low price as Jell-O. Ask your grocer tomorrow for Jell-O chocolate pudding.
This is the last number of the 19th program in the new Jell-O series, and we will be with you again next Sunday night when you will positively hear the bee, even if I have to hum it.
Oh, Jack, another telegram just came in.
Yeah, read it.
It says, forget the violin. I'll give up if you will.
Who's it from?
Cactus Face Elmer.
I'll get him, too. Good night, folks.
Program starring Jack Benny with Mary Livingston came to you over the Red Network of the National Broadcasting Company.
KFI Los Angeles, Earl C. Anthony.